eyes beheld an eerie sight. For my monster from his slab began to rise, and suddenly, to my surprise,
he did the mess.
He did the monster mash.
The monster mess.
It was a graveyard smash.
He did the mess.
It caught on in a flash.
He did the mess.
He did the monster mash. From my laboratory in the castle east to the master bedroom where the vampires feast, the ghouls all came from their humble abodes to get a jolt from my electrodes.
So, baby, when they remove your spleen, they make a small incision on... Oh, sorry. Excuse me. Dr. Dread Reviews, 1977. That old classic, Shockwaves. Take one. Rolling. Hey, this is your old friend, Dr. Dread. And let me tell you, when it comes to horror movies, you really can't go wrong with Shockwaves, 1977. And the reason you can't go wrong with that movie is because that movie stars Peter Cushing. Peter Cushing, the master. The movie also has John Carradine. And John Carradine has an internet movie database page that has like 7 million different roles. I mean, he was in everything. Check it out, probably Hawaii 5-0 also. So, let's talk about Shockwaves a little bit. It was one of those Nazi movies, you know, Nazi zombies. How far into this should I, spoilers? Did you say spoilers? Spoilers, spoiler alert, spoiler alert. So anyhow, there are spoilers. The movie was made in 1977, and it was like the same year that Star Wars was released. And no heartbeat. And it was the same year that Star Wars was released. And John Carradine in that also. So we're gonna talk about Shockwaves and give you just what was going on. Okay, group of people on a yacht in the ocean. John Carradine is the captain. Ghost ship, boom, crash, deserted island, Peter Cushing on the island, and then the very best part of the movie is the underwater Nazis that rise slowly up. You know, and when I think of it, Shockwaves, it's really reminiscent of Gilligan's Island. You know, a couple of girls, a couple of guys, deserted island. Then everything goes horribly wrong. The underwater Nazis are out of control, and they are no longer listening to their commanding officer, Peter Cushing, and they're just on a murderous spree. And anytime they get a chance, they pop up out of the water and they grab somebody. Not much of a plot, but the pacing's really good. And what's really stand out and awesome about this movie, other than the underwater scene, the rising up out of the water, which that's creepy stuff. But the standout thing about this movie is the score. Just watch it for the music, and you'll disagree with me, but the score is awesome. You may recognize a couple of people from this movie, and then again, you might not. Brooke Adams, who later went on to star in Invasion of the Body Snatchers. She is the main heroine in this movie. And then the heroic tough guy would be Luke Haplin, who you may recognize from the show Flipper back in the 70s. Flipper, Flipper, splash, 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 splash. showing my age, aren't I? So, Dr. Dre is going to recommend that you look for shockwaves. If you look hard enough, you can find it online, and you can probably stream it right to your television set. It might not cost you anything if you don't mind foreign subtitles. Look for the movie. Let me know if you like it. And as always, my friends, keep it scary. Dr. Dre, hoping you have a fantastic one. Cut it like a spleen. Cut!
I was working in the lab late one night when my eyes beheld an eerie sight. For my monster from its slab began to rise, and suddenly, to my surprise, he did the monster mash.
The monster mash.
It was a graveyard smash.
He did the mash.
It caught on in a flash.
He did the mash.
He did the monster mash. From my laboratory in the castle east to the master bedroom where the vampires feast, the ghouls all came from their humble abodes to get a jolt from my electrodes.